Hatusemi zaidi ya hayo.
Tunasema. Tunasema.
Unasema.
We are boarding.
Festival of that is still there.
100. That one you throw it dungazu ku inje.
Yeah, 100.
This 10 parties. 100. 100. There are 3. 100.
How old are you, kijana?
I'm a Liban national anthem.
So a sponsor who sponsors up to the finals, ni kama unachukua tu pesa unatupa kwa lake. Hata ya lake ni afadhali fish itakula.
This is the Daily Nation on for dated Friday, March 11th, 1988.
Where were you in 1988?
1988, I was a year old. I was just starting to see things. To be able to see that this one is an eye, a nose.
Kumaanisha huko karibu kutoka bracket ya youth.
Mimi nilishatoka bracket ya youth. No, but baba bado si ni youth.
Baba bado ni youth.
Then me bado ni youth.
Okay, so
allow us to take you through a political journey.
Not just political. So this gazette is older than me, so that's why we found it interesting. So when we were reading it, tuligundua kuwa Kenya has been the same
all along.
Like the years are going, but we've just been the same. The issues that were talked about in this newspaper, if you buy today's Daily Nation, you would probably find the same things.
You just change names.
Yeah, we change names and the price of things and the money people have stolen. But
So I was also trying to make a list of the interesting issues that were addressed in the paper, just to peruse. These videos are here when they are so long. You guys don't watch up to the end. Anyway, should you wish to watch up to the end, these are the things we have lined up for you. From this newspaper, 1988. There is the theme is nothing changes if nothing changes. Clearly nothing has changed.
Clearly.
Politicians are still abusing each other. Kenyans are still divided on either side. And they're just people who think Kenya is theirs to play in the way they want.
And there are people who are still stealing billions.
Yes, billions were being stolen from back then.
In 1988.
So, nothing changes if nothing changes. The event is political clashes. We shall see how. And then, cuckoo, cuckoo, why? Why?
I do this.
Anyway. Kaplem kamekubali. Then there is the issue of Tigray.
Yes. Tigray has been fighting since 1988.
Ah, you guys are not serious. Tigray, 1988. Huh. And then there's men with secret second wives. With secret second wives. Moto imekubali. I think the fire is agreeing with the events that are being said in the newspaper. There's men with secret second wives. This is not my own personal view, but the view of the Daily Nation. They did it back then.
Yeah.
And then there was money heist then in 1988.
People were stealing from Gava.
Yes.
Billions.
And then there's vice presidency supremacy. Imagine, Izini is a vice president, zillions of them. And you're going to see how it is described in the
newspaper.
From 1988. Yeah. There's the church in politics.
Uh-huh.
Church in politics started in 1988. Wacha hii kitu sahi ati watu wanambiwa, oh, sijui tumuambia musiongei kwa kanisa. This thing started before some of us were born. And we have just been doing it every political year. There's fertilizer at the port. Fertilizer, that one we'll talk about deeply because we're organic farmers. Personally, I have a personal thing to say about that one. We shall revisit. And then there's Rachel Omamo. Is this the Rachel Omamo or is Rachel Omamo now? Or is a striking resemblance?
It's a striking resemblance. So check.
So you'll see whether it is Rachel Omamo from 1988. And then there is psychiatry. And then there's live matches. Live matches is that one. Like ABC. The newspaper is headed Kamoto Michuki Winga. It is Michuki. Or Michuki.
Michuki
for us. Kamoto Michuki wingers in clash. Youth wingers belonging to the two parliamentary candidates for Kangema, Murang'a, Mr. John Joseph Kamotho and Mr. John Njoroge Michuki fought at around midday yesterday before the start of a campaign meeting. Trouble started when some youth wingers blocked the road to the venue at Gikui. So this is 1988 and politicians were using youth as such. The call now is for the youth to be more woke.
Excess passengers from a city matatu take a lift in a police vehicle to the police station yesterday following a clampdown on a renegade public service vehicles. The clampdown, which comes in the wake of an escalating road carnage toll, involves both the vehicles and their operators. Transport and Communications Minister Arthur Magugu has ordered a retesting of matatu drivers, while ministry and national youth service officials will be traveling incognito all over the country monitoring traffic violations. 1988. Watu wa matri walikuwa wanabeba excess 1988 alafu wanapewa lift.
Wanapelekwa station ndani ya Mariamu.
1988. So nothing has changed. This is now the Tigray, the one we are talking about. Tigray rebels. Rebels in the North Ethiopian province of Tigray say they are pulling out of towns, two towns they captured last week, because they could not defend them against an expected counterattack by government troops. The story is on page 2. Tigray started back then.
I don't know if it started back then or if it has been going...
It has been going on since back then, 1988, before we were born. Nini iko Tigray?
I don't know.
Now we are on men with secret second wives. And then 1988 being a political year, I think we should highlight this political ministry.
Before you highlight Ibrahim's.
Ibrahim's used to be there from 1988.
Yes, and check the prices of.
Na kimbo ilikuwa pesa ngapi?
Kimbo ilikuwa 17 bob.
1750?
Yes, 17 bob.
That is 1 kg of kimbo, 17 bob.
Omo 10 bob, imperial leather, 3 bob.
Imperial leather ilikuwa sopi ya wadozi.
Ukiwa na shilingi 12 ungekula chapat.
Baking flour, 2 kgs. Fika kwa duka lako la Ibrahim. Mwaka ukiwa ni 1980. Sayu usijaribu kuenda huko na 12 bob ati. Unataka unga kubwa ya chapo. It might turn ugly. Men with... By the gazette if I kusoma, we need to now read it for last time and then keep it. Kananza kuchapa. There's this thing of men with secret second wives. It says, son...
Yo, go investigate. Go investigate for us. Run. Go check. Come back and report. Yeah. Umetoka kutaga. Farm animal interactions.
So it says, son denies Mutua had second wife. Again, this is 1988. We don't know who this son is and we don't know who this Mutua is. So usijijazie, unless it is relevant, you look like you can jijazie sir. But the son of a former commissioner of prisons, the late Ruben Nzioka Mutua, yesterday told the High Court that he had never known that he had a stepmother. Mr. Stanley Mwendwa Mutua, 24, denied that his father had a second wife. He was testifying in a case in which a woman is challenging his father's will. I only knew this lady as a tenant in a house which my father bought for me in 1980, he told the court. Mrs. Josephine Mumbua Mutua, a secretary with the Kenya Polytechnic, claims to have been Mutua's second wife. She is demanding a share in his estate. Mr. Mutua died in a road accident on May 26, 1986. So this is 1988. Things are happening the way they're happening, and the striking resemblance of events back then and now, word for word, is more than striking. Anyway, we shall continue. There's this one.
Cattle rustling was still happening.
Gatero Secondary School in Rumuturi Division of Laikipia District has been closed indefinitely following a boycott by its 320 students on Tuesday. The school's board of governors is expected to discuss the matter today. There's a money heist, 41 million robbery inquest date set. Says an inquest into the death of Mr. Joseph Wasike Barasa, a driver with a security company who died while in police custody, will be held from March 22nd.
People were dying in police custody.
Yeah, and this one is a driver of a security company. Mr. Baraza died while undergoing interrogation by CID officers in connection with the theft of 41 million.
4.1 million.
The money was being transported from the Mombasa Central Bank of Kenya to the Cooperative Bank along Kuruma Road on January 14th. Hii inakaa inside job. Inside job inakuanga na background kama hii. This one is interesting. So this next one happened in Kieni. It is a story by a correspondent of The Nation then. It says anti-VP rumor refuted at rally. A candidate for the Kieni parliamentary seat, Mr. Richard Munyiri Ndiwa, has claimed that some people are trying to spoil his reputation by spreading rumors that he was against Vice President Mwai Kibaki. So if you just decide to say a candidate for the Kieni parliamentary seat, Mr. So-and-so, has claimed that some people are trying to spoil his reputation by spreading rumors that he was against Deputy President William Ruto. And then 1988 just becomes 2021. So nothing has changed. Prayer contest ensues. This is the church in politics. The story in Buret. That is how it's pronounced. Prayers and heckling dominated a campaign rally in Buret constituency in Kericho district on Wednesday.
Did you just say Kericho?
Kericho. Kericho nini?
I don't know. Kericho. When you mzungu.
Kericho district, yes. Mr. Timothy Mibei and Professor Jonathan Ngeno are the two contenders for the seat. At a joint meeting at Cheplanget Shopping Center, an old man who led the meeting in prayer prayed for Professor Ngeno, the DO, and the chiefs, but omitted Mr. Mibei's name. This prompted booing from Mr. Mibei's supporters, and the old man had to cut his breath. Yani wanasema kama uwezi ombea huyu mheshimiwa wetu, basi maombi si ikaishe. Kwani iko nini?
Si lazima tuombe.
1988. This one is Narok North. Mr. William Timama, a candidate for the Narok North seat, said he was not responsible for the eviction of squatters from Mau Forest, nor was he planning to move people away from the district.
Mau has been there since 1988.
Mau.
Yes.
Okay, and then there's Ahuja.
It is a public address system.
Yeah, Ahuja mawa Ahuja anaka nani?
Anaka Obama.
Yeah. Barack.
Watu wa campaign walikuwa wachache.
And that is a mammoth crowd. In 1988, this one was a mammoth crowd. I don't know if you can see me. Ndio mimi hapo na kakofia. And then there is a cartoon nearby. Who ni Mado?
Is it Mado?
Yes, this one that has nini is signed with eyes. Who else could draw cartoons back in 1988? Seme tu kweli pia. Ni Mado? Mado it is. This is hopeless. Does red mean go or start moving? You know, people trying to crack the highway code. Then there's this part that says they are simply not communicating. 1988. So 2021, the same title still works. They are simply not communicating. Let me read for you. Ever since the election was declared, you pick up a newspaper and there it is. Campaign violence, arguments, boxing drama, harsh campaign language, heckling, collision with DO, so and so kicking someone, etc. So it says the contestants and their supporters behave alike and you cannot tell the difference when you find them arguing. What is wrong with these people? He asks. I think the answer is neatly packed in 12 letters. Lack of communication. Tafuta nakala yako ya 1988. Or one labda will visit the story. That was Paul Ajuoga. Paul O. Ajuoga of Nairobi. Kama unamjua umgote mwambie barua yake ya 1988
imeficha. Imeficha.
Kwa Shaggzlife.
Imeficha ama imefika.
Imeficha.
Leo yungi ya nini nowadays. Ehe, hapa ulikuwa ukieka ngata ya
100. Lux. Imagine.
Ngata.
With every 100 worth of petrol bought, cash at Kobil Kennel Stations, you get free lux. Ama watu walikuwa naenda peti wakiwa wananuka.
Wakapewa tu sabuni.
Watu wangu wanakasabuni. 100 bob.
How much fuel do you think?
In 1988 nilikuwa nadhani 100 bob ni kujaza tank.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Alafu unapewa tu kasabuni. Unapewa
kasabuni. Sahi 100 bob watu wezi nini liter. Non-OPEC sellers. Non-OPEC sellers debate oil price fall.
think that
oil
was the last time.
Oil prices can fall.
I think that was the last time.
The last time oil prices fell was in 1988. So, Kenya mwache kulia. This thing has just been rising ever since.
Fertilizer.
Then there's the issue of fertilizer. There's thousands of tons of fertilizer being offloaded at Mombasa Port. The offloading of DAP fertilizer has taken over a month, but the Kenya Ports Authority has hastened the exercise by using cranes which pour the product into 25 kilogram bags. So I think that is supposed to make it be renewed quickly.
Isambazwe.
So I'm imagining a farmer who was using fertilizer in 1988. Hiyo shambake sahi inakaaje?
Shambake sahi hizi.
It can't produce
unless
anything.
Unless aliacha.
Yeah, maybe if he stopped and started using organic manure.
Mm.
We shall talk about that one on another day.
Buckles was here with us.
Buckles was also here. Ngei Mulinge promised to improve. That is what they have been saying.
Education boost.
Aspirant pledges education. Ile tu kitu watu wanataka. And then there is Omamo. Is this Rachel Omamo?
She looks like her.
Who is Rachel Omamo? Because wife beating says Rachel Omamo, a Nairobi advocate. Is Rachel Omamo the one who is Rachel Omamo today, a Nairobi advocate?
Na saisi, she's a.
Was she a Nairobi advocate then? I think that is the only thing we need to find out. There's this on that extra portion, only with bay mix nyama. So this bay mix nyama, which is a mineral supplement, is made by this company called Bayer Veterinary Division. These Bayer people, they're the same ones who make what?
Pesticides.
And before making pesticides, they used to make what?
Nyama.
Not nyama. I was told kuna tengeneza chemical weapons for killing people. It's just for killing people in those nasty wars back then. Then wars ended and they decided to use that stockpile to make pesticides. So in 1988, they were selling for us bay mix nyama, the mineral supplement with a difference. Watu wa nyama choma?
Museveni.
Museveni. Before Museveni, kuna Pujo. Hebu kuja hapo kwa Pujo. So this is your new sensation. Pujo 205. Kuna ka Pujo hapo.
Na ka model.
Kuna ka model hapo. Ameua.
Hapo
kuna jamaa hapo anakula kwa macho. Alafu kuna huyu naye amevaa helmet hapo. Says, for some, Pujo 205 is too much to handle. Low. So hurry and get your new Pujo 205. It is cool, it is slick, it is wild, and it is exciting.
Back to Museveni.
Hey, Museveni. There's a story of a woman here who was giving Museveni a hard time. Joyu. And it was Alice Lakwena. Now, this Alice Lakwena is one woman who gave Museveni a run for her money. Museveni alikuwa kisikia Alice Lakwena. Watch a size basic yet. It's Gio walking to work. Alice took the nini from Museveni to another level. She had her own brigade.
I like her.
It was saying, Alice Lakwena took Uganda by surprise. So what she did, she said she was sent directly by God to come and overthrow Museveni. Yes. Messenger of God. And she told people to, her followers were supposed to abstain from sex, smoking, drinking, and stealing. Many of their beliefs swayed from the ridiculous to the absurd. So akaambia watu tunaenda kutoa Museveni.
Kumaanisha hakufanikiwa.
Hakufanikiwa kama Museveni bado yuko. Attitudes of Kenyans to psychiatry. Professor David Ndete explains how Kenyans react to psychiatric problems. If back then the problems were there and people were positive about them,
go on the right track.
We're on the right track.
So, sir.
KQ walikuwa anaweza ku afford nini mzima. This KA or KQ?
This KA.
Kenya Airways.
How it turned to KQ, I don't know.
So, it was on 1962. Ndio walipata hii KA. British walikuwa naitumia kunini hivyo wakawapatia chukweni 1963 muite KA. You don't believe?
I don't.
So they need a full page. They must have been the Safaricom of these days. After there's this cartoon of Love Is.
Yeah, hey.
This cartoon has stayed. Wakapu wanakumbuka Love Is.
Hey.
Some people just used to buy magazines, gazette to read Love Is. Alafu wanatupa. So it says Love Is not hiding things from each other.
Are you hiding something from me?
Hiding stuff. So he says love is not hiding things from each other. And then...
Babu alikuwa mnoma, alijaza code word.
Ah, by the way. First in position importance. First in position importance. It is... Unataka kusoma answer?
Premier.
Alafu kuna hiyo? Television?
Television.
This one was the nini?
Ilikuwa tu ni KBC.
KBC, so it was kufungua kituo. Danger Mouse. Nani anakumbuka Danger Mouse?
I remember Danger Mouse.
Teren teren Danger Mouse. Ten 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 ten. Terere. I remember it. Tulikuwa tunapenda cartoon. So kufungua kituo na kufunga kituo. If you tuned in or turned on your TV anytime before 5 a.m. in the morning, you'll just hear shh. Nothing doing.
It was true. It was not shh.
Depends with the TV you had. Ni mulikuwa na ka Great Wall. Great Wall likuwa nafanyanga shhh.
Ni mulikuwa na Panasonic.
Zitu likuwa na kale ka kubwa ka mgongo Panasonic. Kazuwa ka natosha na hivi. Hame waka nafanya tuu. Na nako nakuonyesha rain.
Then when they're opening it used to be to tuu. Tuu.
And then the song.
How old are you, kijana?
I'm going to national anthem.
Yeah, they used to play the national anthem.
You remember that song though?
Next.
Auditing. Now ni kama walikuwa na pesa.
Yes.
You remember it?
Ukitaka kuongeza romance unaenda hapa.
By the way, this one was where?
Foresta.
Foresta Magnetica. Is that restaurant still there? Monya lienda huko atuambie tafadhali. Now there's this person who advertised using Price Waterhouse Associates, and I assume Price Waterhouse, the one me I know, and it ends with Cooper.
Yes, I think they merged with Cooper.
So then it was Associates. Analyst or programmer. Our client, a leader in the tourist industry, wishes to recruit a Kenyan citizen as an analyst or programmer. Our client is looking for a hard-working, independent self-starter. A relevant degree will be desirable, but is not essential. So, in 1988, this person who was looking for this analyst or a programmer is saying a relevant degree will be desirable, but it is not essential. Anataka tu mtu anajua kufanya kazi. And the way the education system has gone now, that is what plagues it.
That people are looking for degrees, not...
People have degrees, alafu sasa kikuja kwa kufanya kazi, mtu hezi fanya kazi, joko tu na hiyo book side of it. Then there is... live matches. 8 and possibly 9 of the 16 matches of the African Cup of Nations matches will be televised by the Voice of Kenya starting on Sunday. Doubt about the 9th match depends on whether Kenya qualifies for the semi-finals on March 22nd and 23rd. If Kenya qualify, then the Kenya Post and Telecommunication will sponsor the semi-final. The other semi-final will be sponsored by the American Life Insurance Company. Meanwhile, a spokesman at the VOK said yesterday that sponsors for any other matches will be welcome. Then there was Darts.
Yeah, remember Darts.
You remember Darts kwa TV?
Yeah.
Festival of Darts is still there. Look, 100! That one you throw it, dunga zuku inje.
Yeah, 100.
This thing for tears. Dunga, 100! 100! There are three. 100! So, as the way we used to play, you come and dunga those three, alafu unaenda kwa game ingine, unacheza badminton, unashinda watu hapo, and then you throw the javelin far in secondary school. Tulikuwa wakubwa kuliko wengine. Unachukua shot put, unarusha, so by the time the other people catch up and you're called, you have already participated in this. You are an all-rounder. So we were called.
All-rounder.
There's this 567 million,
those field guys request mention.
There's the one for 1 billion, this is the one. Two cases in which two coffee exporters have denied charges of failing to remit 567,369,228 shillings and 409,099,204. Unajua pesa lazima uzoe kutaja hivyo ndio nasikia ati inakuja. Unataja stumble, otherwise haitakuja.
Taja basi.
Si nimesha taja?
Oh.
They failed to remit those one to the Kenyan government. So at this time, I was saying, walipotea na pesa yenye ukijumuisha inaweza kuwa karibu 1 billion. And I'm imagining 1 billion in 1988. Mm. Silikuwa pesa mingi sana?
Pesa mingi sana.
Uchumi walikuweko, walikuwa na represent. Aga Khan work. How many people remember this nini of uchumi?
I remember.
Ulinunua nguo huko?
No. Alafu ilikuwa ukishikwa na sore throat, ilikuwa tunatumia Dequadin.
The quad.
It's all lozenges. Become a strepsil like.
So to conclude, nyama yetu imeiva.
Kaliva kitambo hata moto iliisha.
The how are you grooming?
The reality of Kenyan politics today is such that they are politicians and then they are citizens. So with Kenyans, I think when we decide politicians are queer politicians and citizens to the queer citizens, once every 10 years we'll engage in some seemingly serious talk about where the future of the country and where we want to see our economy and things like that. But from 1988 until now, the conversation is still the same. People abusing each other. There's nothing tangible.
People saying what it's due education.
And then now there's also the squabbles about education. And then there's still like EP and degree. This is 1988. Unless we seriously want this to change, I think it starts with each and every single individual. Anajuliza wewe uta change nini? If you are carried by political violence and instability kila mara, you just educate people about that. And then those two, three people umewambia, kama itawaguza kwa roho, they find otherwise it is still the same thing. It will continue 1988. This newspaper, you're going to put it back where we found it, and probably in the year 3088. You know, we never know. Someone might find it, nenda kuifanyia pacha. Someone might find it and look at the story. I hope the story won't be like that then, because mina jua 38 years sitakuwa. Nafika hapa
22.
So, bye.
Ambia watu wa subscribe.
You subscribe to our channel, Shaggzlife.
Like.
Kenya.
Like the video if you found it interesting.
Like a video. Whether or not you found it interesting, because interesting stuff is coming ahead.